Good afternoon, dear students. In this video lecture, I will be teaching you all parallelograms. Now, I hope all of you know the definition of parallelograms. Already, these topics are already covered in class 7th, 8th, and onwards. You have seen, you have read about parallelograms and various types of parallelograms. Here, we are going to mostly deal with the numerical problems related to this chapter. Now, but for an introduction, as a part of an introduction, I would like to give you some information related to parallelogram. First of all, you should know what is a quadrilateral. Now, what is a quadrilateral? A quadrilateral is a plane figure or a rectilinear figure enclosed by four line segments. That means if I have line segment say AB, another line segment CD, and AB, CD, B to C, C to D, A to D, and all those things. Like this, we are having four line segments, right? If I join them in such a way, if I join these line segments in such a way that they form a closed figure. Line segment, rectilinear figure, what is a quadrilateral? A rectilinear figure formed by enclosing these line segments, means joining this line segment. This is a closed figure, enclosed figure, right? Here I will be having like AB, then here we will be having BC, then we are having CD, A to D, and we are having C to D. So if I join all these line segments in such a way that it forms a closed figure having four sides, then it will be called as a quadrilateral. Understood? So quadrilateral means a line, say a rectilinear figure or a plane closed figure enclosed by four line segments is called a quadrilateral. Now, what is the meaning of vertex? I have been putting again and again my marker here. Means that this is called as a vertex. What is this called? This is called as vertex. Now, what is the definition? What will be the definition of this vertex? Two line segments intersecting at one point. That point is said to be as the vertex of the plane figure. Right now, we are talking about quadrilateral, so it will be called as vertex of a quadrilateral. If I will be talking about parallelograms, it will be called as the vertex of a parallelogram. So, the definition of vertex is that a point obtained when two line segments intersect each other, that particular point will be called as a vertex. Now, all of you are clear about the quadrilaterals? All of you understood what is the definition of quadrilateral and what is a quadrilateral? Then what is a vertex? Now, second thing comes, types of quadrilateral. How many types of quadrilateral are there? First is convex. Second is non-convex. First is convex quadrilateral. The other one is non-convex, or you say concave quadrilateral. Non-convex or concave quadrilateral, they are same. Now, in case of convex quadrilateral, each angle will be less than 180 degrees. Convex quadrilateral means each of the angles will be less than 180 degrees. Now, in case of concave, one of the angles of the quadrilateral will be greater than 180 degrees. Means if we are having four angles in a quadrilateral, all the angles are less than 180 degrees, then it will be called as convex quadrilateral. And if we have a quadrilateral whose angle is greater than 180 degrees, then this type of quadrilateral will be called as concave. Example, this is less than 180, this is less than 180, this is less than 180. But what about this? This is obviously greater than 180 degrees. So this is an example of concave quadrilateral. this is an example of convex. So here we are not going to deal about the quadrilaterals, rather we have to see what is a parallelogram and how it differentiates, how do we get different types of parallelograms. Now quadrilateral means having four sides, based on their sides, based on their angles we have different names. Now I will be discussing about the types of parallelogram. There are total five conditions which makes a quadrilateral to be a parallelogram. If I have a quadrilateral and each of the quadrilateral satisfies any one of the condition which I will be speaking right now, will make that quadrilateral a parallelogram. The first condition says that if each pair of the quadrilateral, each pair of the quadrilateral are parallel. If each pair of the quadrilaterals are parallel, then that quadrilateral is said to be a parallelogram. Let us take an example with the help of drawing. Suppose this figure. If I am having this side parallel to this side, then this will be called as a parallelogram. Each pair of the opposite sides are parallel, then it will be called as a parallelogram. The figure may be like this also. The figure may be like this also, each pair, right? This is more tilting, okay? So this side is parallel to this side. So this is an example of parallelogram. Now second condition is each pair of the opposite sides are equal. Each pair of the opposite sides are equal. Each pair of the opposite sides are equal. That means a figure like this. Opposite sides are equal, then it is called a parallelogram. This is also called as a parallelogram. Suppose I have all the four sides equal, then also it is a parallelogram. Suppose I have this figure, this side is equal to this side is equal to this side, it is again a parallelogram. Okay, now if I have another figure like this, these all are said to be a parallelogram. Opposite sides are equal, opposite all the four sides are equal, all the four sides are equal, angles does not matter. Whatever may be the angle, we are not going to talk about right now. Angle based upon the sides and the sides parallel, we are going to say about the figure to be a quadrilateral to be parallel. Now third type is each pair of the angles are equal. Each pair of the opposite angles are equal. Each pair of the opposite angles are equal. Opposite angle means this angle and this angle are said to be opposite angle. This angle and this angle are equal. These are said to be opposite angles. If this condition comes in front of us, then we can say that the figure, that the quadrilateral is a parallelogram. This is the meaning of opposite side. These are called the meaning of opposite. Whereas these two angles are called as adjacent. Adjacent angles, these are called as opposite. The angles which are placed on the diagonals are said to be opposite angles. And the angles which are placed on the same sides are said to be adjacent angles. These two are called as adjacent angles. Understood? So opposite angles are equal, then we can say that the quadrilateral is a parallelogram. Now we are having another condition, that is fourth condition. If in a quadrilateral the diagonals bisect each other, if diagonals bisect each other and are equal, or rather we can say if the diagonals are equal, no need of bisecting, if diagonals are by equal, diagonals are equal, if diagonals are equal, then also we can say that the figure is a parallelogram. Diagonal, this diagonal is equal to this diagonal. Suppose I am having A, B, C, D. I am saying AC is equal to BD. If this situation is there, if it is given, then we can directly say that this figure is a parallelogram. So this is, these are the four conditions, and the fifth conditions are based upon one pair of the opposite. Fifth condition, most important condition, I would say that one pair of the sides is equal and parallel. Okay, one pair of the side is equal. Till now we were saying each pair of the quadrilaterals are parallel, each pair of these quadrilaterals are parallel, then it is called a parallelogram. Each pair. Okay, I was talking about the diagonal, both the diagonals. Now here I am talking about only one pair of the side which is parallel as well as equal. Suppose I have a figure like this. Understood? This side is equal to this side. This side is equal as well as parallel. One pair of the side is equal as well as parallel, then it is called as a parallelogram. So there are total five conditions which makes a quadrilateral parallel. The first condition says that each pair of the opposite sides are equal. Second can be said as each pair of the opposite sides are parallel. Third can be said as the diagonals are equal. Fourth can be said as the opposite angles are equal. And the fifth, which I say is the most important, which many students forget while calculating the numerical problems, is one pair is equal as well as parallel, then that type of figure is said to be a parallelogram. So only these things should be, I was thinking to teach you here, because already you all know how many types of parallelograms are there, which are parallelograms. So based upon this, you can very easily deduce that a square is a parallelogram, a rhombus is also a parallelogram, all the four sides are equal. Okay, then you can say rectangle is also a parallelogram. Based upon all these conditions, you can very well judge. Now one more thing is that a trapezium is a parallelogram, opposite sides are parallel. Okay, and this oblique sides are there, then also you can say it is a parallelogram. Second, it is a special type. If I have a trapezium, in case of isosceles trapezium, this angle will be equal to this angle and this angle will be equal to this angle. So this is a trapezium, I hope all of you know, and it is an example of isosceles trapezium in which the base angles are equal and the opposite angles are also equal. Diagonals will bisect each other, have not bisect, sorry, it will be of equal measurement, like this angle, this side will be equal to this side and this side will be equal to this side. So we will see this type when we are going to solve, when we will solve any numerical problems, we will definitely see the properties of isosceles trapezium. Now, moving on to, based upon all these conditions, there are another examples that parallelograms are of a special type, like in case of rhombus. So when a parallelogram is given, if I concluded that this all condition makes a quadrilateral to be a parallelogram. Now, to be very specific, in case of parallelogram, if diagonals bisect each other, first of all, diagonals bisect each other and they are equal and they are having 90 degrees. That means diagonals are equal and bisecting each other. Diagonals are equal, bisected and 90 degrees. Then this will be called as rhombus. Second, if we have a figure in such a way that the diagonals are equal, then we can say that this type of figure is a rectangle. If I have another type, like if the diagonals are equal and intersect at 90 degree, if the diagonals intersect at 90 degree, this is as intersect at 90 degree and diagonals are equal, that means D is equal and intersection at 90 degree. Here only diagonals are equal, there is no intersection. Here diagonals are equal, intersect, bisect and 90 degree. Three conditions. Diagonals equal, may not be equal. Okay, diagonals only, let us take as diagonal bisect only. Sorry, diagonals only bisect and they intersect at 90 degree, then it is called as a rhombus. Now moving on to the problems of this exercise, I would like to clean the board so that it will be easy for me to explain the numerical problems based on that. So here I will be discussing question number 2. Question number 2. In question number 1, what you can see is that opposite sides are mentioned, in which we have the variables x and y, and we have to calculate the value of x and y. So here, as per the question number 2, it is mentioned that ABCD is a rhombus and whose perimeter is equal to 16 cm. AB and EC is equal to 3x plus 1 each. Side AC and the rhomb and the diagonal measures 3x plus 1. Then what we have to do, we have to find the value of x as well as the angles, that is angle ADC and angle DAB. Now let's draw a figure first of all. ABCD is a rhombus, okay? ABCD. ABCD is a rhombus, that means all the four sides will be equal. Now AB and AC, where is my AB? AB is here, AC is here. AB and AC, that means they both are equal, their measurements are equal. They are saying AB and AC measures 3x plus 1 each. Each means AB as well as this. And the first sentence says the perimeter of the rhombus is equal to 16. So perimeter of rhombus is equal to 16 centimeter, right? So what will be the each side? Each side will be equal to, I can take 4x is equal to 16, x is equal to, no need of taking x, let's take a. Why I'm taking a? Because already we have in question x is already given. So a is equal to 16 by 4, that means a is equal to 4 centimeter. Here I have to assume, let the side be of a centimeter. Understood? Then I will be having that one side is equal to 4 centimeter, here also 4 centimeter, here also 4 centimeter. As per the question, it is given that each side measures 3x, diagonal as well as one of the side, each measures 3x plus 1. So 3x plus 1 will be equal to 4 centimeter, because one side and the diagonal, they both equally measures 3x plus 1 each individually. And I have calculated that the side will be equal to 4 centimeter. So I can compare 3x plus 1 is equal to 4. So 3x will be equal to, x is equal to 1. X is equal to 1. I did not take x here. Otherwise, there could have been a very big mistake that we can make. No. So instead of that, we have to take another symbol, that is another variable a. Now, since you can see here, x is equal to 1, your work is done. Now then, second part they are asking, angle ADC, angle ADC. Where is my ADC? ADC, this angle. Now if you see here, this side and this side, all the three sides are equal and ADC is forming an equilateral triangle. So very easily you can say that angle ADC is equal to 60 degree. Why? All the sides are equal. Reason you can write, all the sides of triangle ADC are equal, or you can say another statement, ADC is equilateral triangle. So this is first case. Now the another part they are asking is DAB. Where is angle DAB? DAB means this complete angle. So initially this was an equilateral triangle, so each angle was 60 60 60. Similarly, here also you will be having 60, 60, 60. So angle DAB will be equal to 120 degree. Sum of two angles. Okay. Now I will be solving question number 6 here. They are saying that ABCD is a parallelogram and the adjacent angles are in a ratio 3:2. Find the value of the angles. Okay. So first of all, let us draw. What is the meaning of adjacent? I have already discussed. Now let me make it clear once again. A, B, C, D. Angle A and angle C, these two will be called as opposite angle. Angle B and angle B will be called as opposite angle. But angle A plus angle B means these two angles will be called as adjacent. B this two will be called as adjacent, this two will be called as adjacent. Similarly, this two will also be called as adjacent. Now, the angles are given in a ratio 3:2. 3:2, that means 3x and 2x. So, I can assume let the common factor be x. Then, angle A is equal to 3x, angle B is equal to 2x. And we know that sum of the adjacent angles of a parallelogram is equal to 180 degrees. So I can write 3x plus 2x is equal to 180. So 5x is equal to 180 degrees. X is equal to 36 degrees. If you simplify this, you will get 180 by 5 is equal to 36. 5 threes are 15 and 5 sixes are 13. So therefore, angle A is equal to 3 into 36, that means 108 degrees. Angle B is equal to 2x, that means 2 into 36, 72 degrees. Similarly, angle A will be equal to angle C, so you can also write angle C. Angle B will be equal to angle D, so you can write angle D. So you got all the four angles of the given parallelogram. Now, how we said that these two? Now, I hope all of you must be knowing the angles measurement in case of parallelogram. If you are not clear, let me make it clear. ABCD is a parallelogram. Let us take this as an example. Okay. Now, this line is parallel to this line. This is a transversal. So, you know, these two angles will be called as co-interior angle in case of parallel lines and transversal. In class 8, we have seen parallel lines and transversal. Two parallel lines, one transversal. This angle, these two angles, their sums, they are said to be 180 degree. Why? Co-interior angle. Similarly, these two angles will be transversal. This is a transversal, this is parallel lines, 180 degree. In the same way, you can see here also, like this line is parallel to this line. So, this is a transversal. So, these two angles will be forming co-interior angles. So, their sum will be equal to 180 degree. So, based upon this concept only, we have solved, we have calculated the value as 36 degree x value, and double of x will be equal to 72 and triple of x will be equal to 108 degree. Now, based upon this, you can solve the rest of the sums. The only thing is that you all have to practice, my dear students. Unless you practice, you won't be able to understand the numerical problems. You have to go through the examples. You have to go through the exercise problems. And if you have any problem, then you can ask me any of the problems from this chapter. I hope I will be able to clear it as soon as possible, as I will get from you all side. Thank you.